Can I thank everybody for those contributions? I'm now going to go back to replies from our keynote speakers. Mr. Adesina.
Yeah, thank you very much, Honourable Speaker. I want to thank all the Honourable Speakers for all that you said. I think the key, I just want to comment on three things. First is the divide between the rural and the urban area. I think that one is very, very critical because most of those that will suffer the consequences of climate change in our world today are those in the rural areas, and they are least able to actually support that. So I think that's very, very important for us to do. The second is that we need to also support greater digitalization. And I really like those points that were made because we need to make sure that we have a lot more financial inclusion. Because if you have financial inclusion, they have people have more resources to also be able to adapt to the changes that we see all around us. And finally is the issue of how we help developing countries in particular to deal with exogenous climatic shocks. We have something at the African Development Bank that is called it's a facility anyway, to help countries to insure themselves against exogenous climatic shocks. It's very, very important to be able to pay for premiums for that. So the least developed countries, the small island states, don't have the resources to adapt. And that facility for us is about $250 million. We need to be able to use that facility to support countries so they can get payouts of maybe about $1 billion. It's going to be very, very important for them. And finally is the role that you all play as Honourable Speakers in terms of legislations. I think for me, I feel very encouraged today, Honourable Speaker, that I'm here to see the leaders of our Parliament actually giving voice to the issue of climate, the issue of inclusion, and the issue of social participation in the process. So I want to really thank you very much. All I want to do is just to thank you for really inviting me to be here, and thank you for your leadership as we build a world that is more prosperous and a world that we can live a better future for all of our children and grandchildren. Thank you very much, Honourable Speaker.